Okay, we will move on to next lecture by Professor PBS Bhadoria.
So this is the project which Dr. Chetan talked in the morning. This is a demand-driven project. Really. The demand comes from the NGO or SHG or other people, and then we develop products which has to be affordable, cheaper, and efficient in terms of production and quality. So we take care of these things while developing products. Then we give them to NGOs, SHG for testing and trial. Once it is good, then it is good. We believe in that. Discussing with the stakeholders, developing a product, once it is good, then it is good. Otherwise, we can make them fool. We have been doing that. We talked about the puff rice machine. The lady makes only 4.5 kilo in 1 hour. Now she can make 40 to 50 kilo in 1 hour. She makes 1.5 quintal in 3 to 4 hours. Net profit is 7 rupees per kilo. Makes about 1,000 rupees per day. 3 days she makes mudi, and her income has jumped from 3,000 to 12,000 per month. Now she has sent her son to Calcutta to study science. Yeah. We have given other units, like in other place where he was selling eggs. Now he makes mudi. This is where the people leave rice in the night, and then makes pucks in the morning. The lady who is widow and have 2 kids, Anganwadi worker, and then gave this machine to them. Now they are earning 9,000 rupees per month. Then demand came from urban areas. They wanted a compact, portable puck machine, and which is gas-based, because we don't have firewood in the cities, and making smokes all health hazards. So now we have given this unit earlier. They're making about 40 kilo an hour, which is LP gas-based mudi machine. And it's so much in demand, we are not able to meet demand by looking for manufacturer who can manufacture these units. The second unit is potter wheel. This is his father, and this is his son, you know. When we gave this product to this fellow, the boy was in Bombay. And then father told, come back, we have a machine from IIT. And he started working on this. He modified a little bit. He makes 2,000 diya in a day. Profit is 800 rupees per day. He makes 16,000 rupees per month. He has a recurring deposit of 9,000 rupees, FD of 3 lakhs rupees. He has made his pie house pakka, 2 wheelers. And he was making only 300 diya. Now he makes 2,000. Then he approached that, can you give a another machine which makes lager product? This was good for smaller products, making matka or gamla. Then we have made this electrified potter wheel. And now he makes 3,000 diya from this. So it's 1,200 rupees per day is income. 20 days he works, rest of the time he sells, market, everything. This is very common in Bengal, what we say, dhaki rice, leg pounding, which is water is, rice is good quality because brown rice, we say brown rice, it's a value, have high nutrient values as compared to mill rice. And we really want to revive the systemically. So they do it, you know, you need about 2-3% to operate these machines, and a lot of hazards. So we have mechanized it. Now only 1 person can operate, and productivity is 4 to 5 times. This machine is great demand. In fact, I have given to few NGOs, DRCS, phone unit, we have given to some other NGO unit, and also some engineering college, and they want to manufacture large scale and give to people so they can make rice, brown rice, and sell to market, which is facing very high price, 2-3 times more than the mill rice. they can make atta also. During Pongal, you know, atta is made for pitha, all that, and they pick up. They queue up in the morning and they make atta, and then this fellow also makes brown rice from this machine. Third one is motorized, you know, they do it by hand. It's very cumbersome and very hazardous for women. Most of the technology are actually related to women and then drudgery reducing. She makes only 3 to 4 kilo in a whole day. And when now she can make about, I think about 10 kilo, 20 kilo in a day, 6-7 times more with this machine. You can feed grass, get twisted. This was the first model. It's about both pedal as well as motorized. Now it is totally motorized. We are a little bit improved because it's a little protected and safety, and then other things, so it looks a little more attractive. Again, jute, they do it by hand, twisting by hand, you know. They make about 300 to 400 gram a day. Now they make about 1 kg by 2.5 kg as against, this is pedal operated, just costs 800 rupees. Now they are asking for motorized. We have developing motorized, developed and paid already. This is slicing bamboo. They want to make a basket because they have to have uniform quality, uniform thin, so they can get better product. So you can it can range from 1.2 millimeters, the thin. Thinner is still better, and you can go up to 6 feet long. And that's what you can always make good quality basket. This again, they are asking for chuda making machine. It makes about 10-12 kilo chuda in an hour, clay. And that's also in demand. This is a jamun juice extractor. Now seeds are separated, and you can collect juice. But this is not yet being demanded by the NGOs. Thus, they wanted can you develop a product for us? And so we have developed product. The concept is food, is drugs. You can make about 4 to 5 liters in a day, in an hour. This concept on charkha, you know, they generally by hand operated, but something goes wrong, you have to stop it. So we have made it a concept is pedal operated. So you have more force, you can work longer time, and you can increase the spindle from almost you double the spindles and without any pain. And you know, with the heart is very close to hand and you have problem. So we have given these units to KBIC in Jharkhand. They are using it clearly. This is a, we say, mat making machine. They do it by hand, it's very cumbersome. Then we introduce a stick feeding, hand stick feeding. Now it is motorized. So the stick comes, you can feed the grass, and pull and post, you can make a mat. Yeah, can I show the video? Just 3 minute video, which I made it in my lab actually. We have videos for the technology, yes.
RUTAC, the Rural Technology Action Group, has been conceptualized with a focus on upgradation of rural technologies with the help of IITs and local NGOs. Sponsored by the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India, the RUTAC unit of IIT Kharagpur has taken up a number of technological initiatives to develop and upgrade existing rural technologies during the last 8 years. So far, more than 50 NGOs and self-help groups are connected to implement the technologies in the four eastern states of West Bengal, Bihar, Odisha, and Jharkhand. These technologies have helped villagers to generate employment opportunities at village level and improve their income. The integrated Mori making machine has increased productivity by 10 to 15 times and is being used by several self-help groups in the region. Manifold improvement in paddy production has been achieved with mechanized dheki. An improvement of at least 10 times has been achieved with motorized sabai grass rope making machine. Pedal driven potter wheel raised the production by 7 times. That technology has been transferred to local potter clusters. Several other rural technologies like foot-driven amber chakra, motorized mat stick feeding machine, and doormat making machine has been successfully being used by local self-help groups. RUTAC, the Rural Technology Action Group. RUTAC.